обережно двері зачиняються. Наступна зупинка.
Why do you call Ukrainian babushkas Nazis? That's how we live in Kiev. And today is the 24th of February. It's been 2 years of a full-scale war already. Look at this Nazi. Russians. It's been 2 years of a full-scale war already, and you may ask, how has your life changed? All I can say, we have become stronger. Hello everyone, greetings from the capital of freedom. In this video I will show you how we, ordinary residents of Kyiv, live in the capital of freedom in Kyiv during the wartime under constant Russian attacks. Let's get started.
You know, Russians are so predictable. The second anniversary of a full-scale war, and Russians are launching their missiles at Kyiv to celebrate this date.
It's been 2 years already since the Russians started a full-scale war against peaceful Ukraine. And in this video I will show you how we live, how we are trying to survive. And it seems we are living on the edge, we are living on the eve of the imminent disaster.
Але водночас 730 днів надії на найвищу справедливість, яка полягає в тому, що у всіх нас різні історії початку війни, але має бути єдиний фінал цієї війни. І буде перемога.
So, how does it feel to live in Kyiv right now in February 2024? You know, when you are reading depressing news all the time, when you are reading that Russians are advancing everywhere, that the Ukrainian army lacks weapons, that foreign media are already calculating how many Ukrainians will leave Ukraine if Putin wins. By the way, they say that 20 million of Ukrainians will leave Ukraine. If 20 million will leave, who will be living in Ukraine? There is a very popular expression right now in Ukraine. Let me cite it correctly. So Ukraine will either be free or Ukraine will be depopulated, because nobody wants to be a Russian slave. Death of freedom, you know. Death or freedom? Look here, it is written donate today to see tomorrow. So, what's the news in Kyiv? Your favorite babushkas are still here waiting for the Russian missile attack. Someone asked me, why do you call Ukrainian babushkas Nazis? Because they are typical Ukrainian Nazis.
typical residential blocks for Kyiv. By the way, one of them was hit by the Russian missile last summer, and a 30-year-old woman was killed. So many civilians have been killed by Russians. How do you think? Will Russians attack us this night? Last night they attacked Odessa. Again they hit a residential building. Again civilians were killed. Yeah, Russian boss, am I telling the truth?
So, what's the news in Kyiv? What's the news in the capital of freedom?
And while I was cooking borscht, another Russian valuable aircraft was shot down. Maybe I should cook slower. It seems I'm becoming a typical Ukrainian babushka. Now I'm interested only in seedlings. Look here, I have never seen such tomato. I'm getting ready for spring and I don't know what to buy. I would buy all flowers. Babushka Katya has taught me how to plant beetroot. What? It's a sign. Again, cucumbers. Okay. So, I think it's time to drive to the village. At least I will show you a typical Ukrainian shop.
So, what's the news in Ukraine? Spring is in the air, look here. And despite Russian missile attacks, despite sleepless nights, we are enjoying spring. Actually, today is the end of February, but anyway, +8 feels like real spring in Kyiv.
Planting seedlings, because we are getting ready for spring. Have you decided to plant seedlings on your own? Richie! Що ти робиш? Ukrainian soil is the best in the world. Sometimes I think it was one of the reasons Russians decided to attack us. Now, especially for you, a life hack from Ukraine. What are you doing, Rich? Помощник. Ну что ты робишь? Ну что ты робишь?
Richie, right now Russians are launching their missiles at Kyiv again, but they will never break our spirit, and I'm getting ready
for my village adventure.
And as I have promised in every video, I'm reporting you on my progress in drone assembling drones for the Ukrainian army. So if even philologists have started assembling drones, I think there is a hope. We will win for sure. Ukrainians will win.
Okay, we are learning new words. Honestly, I didn't know all these words even in Ukrainian.
Looks very symbolic. Richie.
Приблизно прикидаємо, як воно клеїться, потрібно, щоб десь цей паттерн збігся, і ми знімаємо паперову цю нижню частину і клеїмо. Знімаю на цьому етапі резинок, ви просто їх не вставляєте, стікуєте цей степ і так далі. А тепер ми починаємо з того, що складаємо саме стільки і ось це
підсилення.
Для того, щоб зібрати ці підсилення рами, це задня частина. Це передня. Нам потрібні будуть винтики з нашого комплекту. Стільки нам вони потрібні будуть пізніше. І знаходимо наші 4 резинки. І зараз ми будемо просувати ці резинки. Тут нам потрібно взяти іншу таку, меншу детальку. Її потрібно встановлювати саме таким чином. Тут є менший виріз і більший виріз, і більший виріз. Накрутили іншу. Має вийти ось так. Тепер повторимо те ж саме з іншою стороною. Це просто звичайний поролон, який допомагає дрону при посадках, наприклад, на асфальт. Не дряпати там винти, не пошкоджувати саму раму. Я б не сказав, що це якась дуже важлива річ, але якщо вона не потрібна, її можна здерти в будь-який момент. Якщо вона у вас є, то це пару секунд її наклеїти. Давайте. Ось ми вдягнули. На цьому етапі я рекомендую відразу його зажати, щоб він не рухався, не випадав цими пластиковими гайками, які ми раніше відклали в сторону. Також ми будемо його паяти.
Thank you for watching. Pray for Ukraine. And goodbye.